Want to learn how to master Apple Mail? Well, watch closely because I'm going to give you 10 essential tips to make sure you're maximizing your productivity. I guarantee you're not using all these features. And make sure to stick around until the end because I'll show you how you can download all these tips for free. So let's jump in. Let's start with some powerful quick actions and filtering tips that will make managing your inbox a breeze. To use filters, tap the filter icon at the bottom left of your screen. This icon looks like a small circle with three horizontal lines. Then tap unread in the bottom center of the screen. You can filter by unread, flagged, or emails with attachments. You can also filter by VIP or recent emails, which are incredibly useful if you're looking for something specific. For even quicker actions, use two fingers to select multiple emails at once. Just tap with two fingers and drag down to select more emails. You can then delete, flag, or move them to another folder all at once. If you want to quickly access your drafts, press and hold the Compose button in the lower right corner. This brings up a list of all your drafts, so you can pick up right where you left off. These quick actions make managing your inbox faster and more efficient. Next, let's talk about taking search to the next level. Here's how to enhance your search. To search by attachment type, just type spreadsheet, PDF, or any other file type into the search bar, and Apple Mail will filter emails with those attachments. You can even add keywords to the search to further filter the results. For instance, I'm going to search for PDFs and the word mortgage. You can quickly filter and find what you're looking for. As you type, Apple Mail offers additional filters to narrow down your results in the suggestions section below. You can search within flagged emails, specific mailboxes, or even unread messages. To search by date, simply type the date or even month like July 2024 in the search bar. You can also type last week or last weekend, and Apple Mail will pull up all the emails from that time frame. These advanced search techniques can save you tons of time when looking for that one important email. Next up, let's talk about smart mailboxes. These are a great way to keep your inbox organized by automatically filtering emails into specific categories. You can even set up different notifications for your VIP contacts. Here's how to make the most out of smart mailboxes and VIP settings. Go to your mailboxes screen by tapping in the top left corner. Now tap Edit in the top right corner. Apple Mail comes with preset smart mailboxes like unread, flagged, and VIP, which you can quickly enable to filter your inbox. A mailbox is simply a folder where you can organize your email messages. For example, you can enable a mailbox that shows only emails with attachments, emails scheduled to send later, or emails that have a reminder. We can also tap New Mailbox to create a new folder to store emails. Give the mailbox a name and select which account it belongs to. In addition to these folders and filters, we can configure a list of VIPs. Tap VIP, and then you can add people from your contact list. When you add VIP contacts, you'll notice a star icon next to their names in your inbox, making it easier to spot important messages. But we can also set different notifications for them to make sure they are front and center. I typically have email notifications turned off for everyone except for VIPs. After you add your first VIP, you'll be able to configure alerts and notifications for them. You can do this by tapping the I that appears next to your VIP folder, then tapping VIP alerts. Make sure that alerts and badges are enabled. Then when you tap on sounds, you can enable haptics and also the audible alert you want. Now, let's discuss two features that most people don't know are available in Apple Mail on the iPhone: scheduling a later time to send an email and setting a delay for when you hit the send button. Let's start with scheduling emails. Start by composing your email. Once your email is ready, hold down the send button. You'll see options pop up to schedule your email. Select when you want the email to go out, later today, tomorrow, or pick a custom date and time. We'll choose 1 hour for this particular email. Your scheduled emails will remain in your send later folder until they are sent, so you can still access and edit them if needed. One quick tip: make sure that your device is on and connected to the internet in order for it to send. If you get on an airplane and turn off Wi-Fi, the email will not go out. Now, let's look at how to send delay. Head over to Settings, Mail, then scroll down and tap on Undo Send Delay. You can choose a delay of 10, 20, or 30 seconds. This delay acts as a buffer, giving you a moment to reconsider or tweak your email before it's gone. Simply tap Undo Send and it'll let you edit the message and cancel it if you choose. We're up to tip number 5. Have you ever been halfway through an email and realized you needed to check something in another message? Apple Mail lets you minimize your draft and browse through your inbox without losing your place. Here's how to get the most out of this feature. While composing an email, swipe down on the draft to minimize it. You'll see the minimized draft appear as a small bar at the bottom of your screen with the subject or title of the email displayed. If you're working on multiple drafts, you can minimize more than one at a time. Each minimized draft will be stored at the bottom of your screen. Once it's minimized, navigate through your inbox to find the information or attachments you need. To copy and paste text or attachments from another email, hold down on the text or image you need, select Copy, then return to your draft by tapping the bottom of the screen. Once you choose the one you want, tap and hold and select Paste. Did you know you can turn your emails into reminders? This is different from the built-in Remind Me function in Apple Mail, which only lets you set up a simple reminder within the Mail app. However, by using the Reminders app, you can create a task with additional details and manage it alongside all your other reminders in your daily to-do list. Here's how to set it up. Open the email you want to add to a reminder. You can highlight the subject line or any important text from the email. Then tap and hold the text and scroll across the menu and tap Share. Then select Reminders. The text you highlighted will become the title of the reminder. Tap Details, and you configure all the additional reminder details you normally would, such as due date, time, flags, tags, and priority. The best part? Tapping the reminder will take you directly back to the email when you're ready to follow up. Swiping is the quickest and most intuitive way to manage your emails on the go. Swipe right on an email to mark it as read or unread. A partial swipe lets you set a reminder for later. For deleting, swipe all the way to the left to automatically delete the message. You'll see a trash icon appear as you swipe. If you swipe partially to the left, additional options like flagging will appear. And depending on the type of email account you have, you might see archive instead of trash when you try to delete emails. I'll show you how to change this in a moment. If you tap more, you'll access even more options. Across the top, you'll see quick options to reply, forward, or move the email to the trash. When we scroll down, we have a larger menu of options. We can set reminders, flag a message, move messages, or archive them. We can also mute a message thread to stop receiving any notifications from it, or block a sender and move their messages to the junk folder. Did you know you can also customize the swipe options to fit your needs? For instance, a moment ago I pointed out that some people might see archive instead of delete when they swipe. Here's how to customize your swiping actions. Go to Settings, then scroll down, tap on Mail, and swipe down and tap on Swipe Options. The right and left swipes are slightly different from each other. We can customize one action for each. On the left swipe, you'll see options to mark emails as read, flag them, or move them. In addition, on the right swipe, we also have the option to archive. Now, if we want to actually configure a swipe to delete a message instead of archive, we do that at the account level. Tap on Accounts, then tap the account you want to configure. Choose Account Settings, tap Advanced, and then choose Delete Mailbox. The next time you swipe right, the message will be deleted. Now, let's talk about managing message threads, which can save you even more time, especially if you receive a lot of emails from large groups. Go to Settings, scroll down, tap on Mail, and scroll down to the Threading section. Personally, I prefer to collapse all the messages in a thread so I can see the entire conversation in one place. You can enable this by turning on Organize by Thread. I also like to keep the newest message at the top of the thread. Now let's talk about organizing your mailboxes. The Mailboxes screen gives you access to all your folders, making it easier to manage your emails. Here's how to set it up. First, go back into Mailboxes. On the next screen, we can see all the folders and all the mailboxes I have installed. To customize the view, tap Edit in the top right corner. When you toggle on a filter such as Send Later, Apple Mail will group all these emails together in one view, helping you organize based on their content. You can also drag and move these folders in the hierarchy to order them any way you want. As we scroll down, we'll see each of our mailbox accounts we have installed. I have a Yahoo account and a few Gmail accounts installed. If I choose one of the folders, I could rename it by tapping on the folder's name. I can also tap Mailbox Location and move it to a different position in the folder structure of that account. If you no longer need a folder, you can delete it, but keep in mind that deleting it will also delete all the emails stored in it. Finally, to get the most out of Apple Mail, you need to dive into the settings. Go to Settings, scroll down and select Mail as before. And from here, we can manage our accounts by adding or removing email accounts like iCloud, Microsoft, Google, Yahoo, AOL, or Outlook. You can also set a default account for your emails, which helps streamline outgoing emails from the correct account. You can adjust the preview lines to see more or less of each email in your inbox, up to 5 lines. As we discussed, we can also customize swipe actions and manage threading options. Another important setting is customizing your email signatures. You can create separate signatures for each work or personal account, ensuring your emails always look professional and appropriate for the situation. If you want to download all these tips for free, use the link in the video description below. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tech tips, and I'll see you in the next video.